Hi, and welcome to Wildlife Wednesday. You're probably wondering, why is Jerry wearing a cycling helmet? And what's that got to do with a sleeping baby chimp? Well, actually, these two things are connected. And that's what this Wildlife Wednesday is all about. I'm Jerry Ellis. This is Apes Like Us. So why would I be wearing a helmet? Well, whenever I do something kind of crazy, like cycling and hurling down a mountain at 40 kilometers an hour, it's a really smart idea for me to wear a helmet because it's protecting my brain. Unfortunately for chimpanzees, orangutans, and other apes, as they're flying around the canopy of the forest, they can't wear helmets, or at least they can't yet. Anyway, maybe we come up with helmets for chimps and apes. But anyway, they aren't wearing helmets, so if they crash into a branch or they fall, it could be a really disastrous thing. Well, over the last couple of weeks, we've been putting together a story for you called Saving Sonia, and that will be up pretty shortly on the channel. But that story is about a tiny little chimp, this chimp, Sonia, and what happened to her when she took a really horrible fall. A couple of months ago, I was filming in Sierra Leone at Takagama Chimpanzee Sanctuary. And the day before I was about to leave the country, that morning we had this massive, massive lightning, thunder, just the craziest storm you've ever seen. Classic tropical rainstorm. And boom, there it goes off right at dawn. Well, a couple hours later, some of the keepers noticed that little Sonia's mom was carrying her around, just like a limp little rag in her hand. It was, I mean, there was no life to her at all. We thought she might be dead. But the only way to find out was to get her back from mom and check her out. And so the keepers, along with vet Andrea Pizarro, they went to work. They coaxed the female back into a small enclosure so that they could dart her. And once they did, they were able to rescue little Sonia. Andrea went running off to the vet clinic and started doing all kinds of immediate emergency procedures on her. One of the things that we discovered right away was by pricking her hands, her feet, shining a light into her eye, there was just no reaction. She was breathing, her heart was going, but there was no sort of consciousness. So had she suffered a concussion? That was our main concern. She had this huge contusion on her left eye, and it was all swollen, but we couldn't see any outer damage to the brain. Well, that was the question that was really a biggest concern was, had she damaged her brain? Did she have a concussion, and what next? So that got me thinking, and especially as we've been editing, that got me thinking about our neocortex. And then I went, where did that come from, our neocortex? Oh my God. So I had to like scramble for, go do a old, you know, sort of a Google lookup on neocortex and refresh my primate biology brain. And the thing that was kind of funny was I thought, where did the word neocortex come? Well, it actually came from my neocortex. Because that's the part of your brain where we hide all that stuff, where we hide all this information in the part of your brain that allows us to do something that's called plasticity, grow and think and do that. Like why humans can learn calculus or how we learn to tie our shoes. That has to do with the plasticity of this thing called the neocortex. Well, the neocortex in all apes carries some pretty special functions. And I thought that would make a great Wildlife Wednesday to talk about this unique thing that we have in which is our brains, or most of our brains. So as you can see from this diagram, the brain has kind of a mass there, but almost 75% of that mass is made up with our cortex, our neocortex and other parts of it. Well, you probably recognize them as these wriggly folds, squiggly bits with their deep furrows. It kind of looks like a big old pile of pasta, pinkish pasta. Well, those foals are called solshi, and the others are called gyri. And together, that makes up your neocortex. But what it does is it helps control sensory perception, motor commands, spatial reasoning, conscious thought, and in us apes like me and you, language. So that's where all of that comes from. And the plasticity behind that is crucial because it allows us to learn and be flexible at thinking and ideas. For a chimpanzee, it's like learning to use a stick as a fishing tool or grooming. All that grooming and social behavior that's learned, that comes from the plasticity of your neocortex. So you can see it's really important at this crucial point in her little life that Sonia has a brain that's working properly and that the neocortex is not damaged. Or otherwise, she may survive, but she may spend the rest of her life at the sanctuary struggling to just be a normal chimp. Well, that's the story that we're going to be putting together for you and showing you in the next few weeks. Anyway, that's your Wildlife Wednesday for this week. You learned a little bit about your neocortex and why it's so important to have some plasticity there. Part of that plasticity, so I can do these Wildlife Wednesdays, I guess, evolve and adapt every week and come up with something new. Anyway, I'm Jerry Ellis. I will put some notes down below in the show notes about your brain and about your neocortex and some links so you can chase down more information if you want about this amazing organ that we have sitting up there on top of our heads. As always, please subscribe to the channel. You can do that by clicking right up there. And you can also see another piece that we've done, either Wildlife Wednesday or, previous Wildlife Wednesday. Take a look at one of those. Anyway, you can check those all out. And until next Wednesday, I'm Jerry Ellis. For everybody at Apes Like Us, thanks for watching and have a great week. Bye-bye.